I have a quick and fun trick for you today, and it's called ratio switch, when one ratio changes into a different ratio. It's a relatively simple trick. There are a few steps to it, but once you know it, you'll know how to do it for all types of ratio switch question. There's not many ways they can vary it. It's the same method applied again and again. First off, how do we identify a ratio switch question? It's when you see one starting ratio and there's a change to the amounts and then a new ratio is created. So two different ratios, one ratio switching into a different ratio. For example, the question you can see in green at the top. Philip and Arif have sweets in the ratio 6 to 11. If Arif gave Philip 5 sweets, then Philip and Arif would have sweets in the ratio 13 to 21. How many sweets does Philip have? One ratio, 6 to 11, has now switched or changed to become another ratio, 13 to 21, obviously because the amounts of sweets have now changed. What do we do? It's a tough level question for both the GRE and GMAT. You can attempt the question if you want on your own, but not many students know how to do it without some sort of training. So what do we do? First off, we must think of ratios as fractions. Look at that first ratio, 6 to 11. You're used to seeing it with a colon, aren't you? 6 with two dots, 11. But you can also write it as a fraction, 6 over 11. As I've written at the bottom, ratios are fractions in disguise. I know what you're thinking. First of all, where did the x come from? And second of all, why are we writing it as a fraction? But let's explain that in a moment. First, why do we have an x there? The x is useful in terms of 6x over 11x because it stands for the unknown multiplier. When it says Philip and Arif have sweets in the ratio 6 to 11, it doesn't mean that Philip literally has 6 and Arif literally has 11, although that's possible. There could be some sort of multiplier. So it could be 12 to 22 if x was 2, or 18 to 33 if x was 3. The x is the multiplier. That ratio 6 to 11 can be scaled up. You could multiply both of them by 2, and that's the reality, 12 to 22. Multiply both of them by 4, 24 to 44. We don't know how many actual sweets there are, we just know the ratio, which is why we don't just write 6 over 11. We write 6x over 11x. And what about the second question? Why are we writing it as a fraction rather than our favorite colon? You're used to writing it as a colon, so it's kind of weird. Why are we suddenly writing it as fractions? Because it's much easier to adjust a fraction than it is to adjust a colon. So now that the ratio is going to change, there's going to be some sort of switch involved, we need to write it as a fraction. So I hope I've sold you on the fact that we can write the ratio 6 to 11 as the fraction 6x over 11x. Now, what about the changes? Arif gave Philip 5 sweets. There has to be some sort of change, otherwise why would the ratio change? So how do we incorporate this change that Arif gave Philip 5 sweets? What happens to Arif's amount and what happens to Philip's amount? Well, you can probably answer that and say that Philip's amount goes up by 5 and Arif's amount goes down by 5. Philip was the 6x, so he goes up by 5, and Arif was the 11x, so he goes down by 5. So I've asked the question, if Philip is in the numerator, because he stands for the 6, and Arif is the denominator, how do we adjust the fraction? We do it like this. We add 5 to the numerator, which is Philip, take away 5 to the denominator, which is Arif. This reflects the fact that Philip gained 5 sweets, and Arif lost 5 sweets. So we write the fraction in a slightly changed way now. You could do this on a new line on your page. So far, hopefully it's making sense. I think I've sold you on the 6x over 11x thing because we've changed the ratio into a fraction and x stands for the multiplier that we don't know and we're trying to work out. And it makes sense that if Philip is the top line and he gains 5 sweets, we add 5. And if Arif is the bottom line, he loses 5 sweets, so he takes away 5 in the denominator. But what do we do now? What do we do with this fact that they tell us this new ratio? The ratio would now be 13 to 21. That's simple. We just make it equal to 13 over 21. Would be or would have means equals. So we write equals the new ratio. Of course, we're going to express that new ratio as a fraction, just like we express the first ratio as a fraction. Now, I know what you're probably predicting. It's going to be equals 13x over 21x. But we don't need x's on the other side, because that ratio is not going to change. So the x's would just cancel out anyway. Point being, you do need x's for that first ratio, which is going to change, but we don't need x's for that second ratio because that fraction is not going to change, and therefore the x's would just cancel out anyway. So we can simply write 13 over 21. The old ratio, 6x over 11x, after the changes, plus 5 on the top, minus 5 on the bottom, becomes the new ratio slash fraction 13 over 21. And now we have a lovely equation that we can solve. I'm going to show you how to solve this equation, and that's going to tell us what x is. And once we know what x is, we know what the actual amounts at the beginning were. Just quickly though, how would we solve that equation? A crucial next step you need to know and be good at is cross multiplying. The 21 on the bottom right of the equation needs to come up and be multiplied by the top left, 6x plus 5. The 11x minus 5 in the bottom left needs to come up and be multiplied by the 13 on the right. So you should have 21 brackets 6x plus 5. That 21 has come up from the bottom right and gone to the top left, and 13 brackets 11x minus 5. The 11x minus 5 has come up from the bottom left and gone to the top right. This is a technique called cross multiplying. If you're not familiar with it, I can maybe cover that in another video. It's a great technique for solving equations when there's a fraction on one side and a fraction on the other side. Now it's just a case of expanding out the brackets, as you can see, and simplifying. I've expanded out the brackets, multiplying the 21 by 6x and 21 by 5, and on the right side as well. Then what I've done with all these big numbers is, for example, I've taken away 126x from both sides to get 17x on the right, and I've added 65 to both sides to get rid of that minus 65 on the right, giving me 170 equals 17x. Dividing by 17, x equals 10. Now, the focus of this video was more on advanced ratios and this ratio switch technique, not so much on solving equations, but I hope that at least gives you a glimpse about how to solve these kinds of equations. I've got other videos on solving equations, so do check them out if this seemed quite advanced. Anyway, the answer isn't x equals 10. What have we actually done? We've found the hidden multiplier. If x is 10, let's go back to that very start of the question where we wrote 6x over 11x. That was the starting ratio. If x is 10, that's 60 over 110. In other words, that's the actual amounts that Philip and Arif had. Philip had 60 and Arif had 110. So the answer to the question is 60 because it was asking about Philip. So yes, that's the secret. We set up one fraction. Then we adjust that fraction, make it equal to the new ratio or fraction, cross multiply, solve. That gives you the multiplier. Once you have the multiplier, you go back to the start and then you know the actual amounts by multiplying. It's a fantastic trick. And yes, I am going to do another example just to bed it in. With this next example, you may well want to pause the video, try and use the technique to see if you can solve it. Some students say, I explain things really clearly, and therefore they think I don't really need to practice because I understand every step. But you can really check if you actually have understood it by pausing when you see this next question. Okay, pause the video and have your best go at this question. It's slightly harder than the last one, but employs the exact same technique. Okay, let's do it. A vet has cats and dogs in its care in the ratio 5 to 7. 10 cats leave the vet's care and 8 dogs join its care. And the ratio of cats and dogs at the practice becomes 2 to 5. How many dogs does the vet now have in its care? Same technique. We write the first ratio as a fraction, 5 over 7, or more specifically, 5x over 7x. Remember, the first ratio always gets the x's. 5x over 7x, the x standing for the unknown multiplier that changes a ratio into an actual amount. Now let's make the adjustments. 10 cats leave the vet's care and 8 dogs join its care. The cats was in the top, so we take away 10 in the numerator, and the dogs were in the denominator. So we add 8 to the denominator. This would give us the fraction 5x minus 10 over 7x plus 8. Now, what do we do with this new ratio, 2 to 5? We make it equal to the fraction 2 over 5. Remember, this second fraction doesn't get any x's because they would cancel out anyway. So we make it equal to 2 over 5. Now here comes the equation solving part of this question, involving one of our favorite new techniques, if it is new to you, or favorite old technique, if you already know it, cross multiplying. That 5 in the bottom right of the equation, 2 over 5, is going to come up and be multiplied by the 5x minus 10. And the 7x plus 8 in the bottom left is going to come up and be multiplied by the 2 on the right. Therefore, we now get a linear equation, 5 times 5x minus 10 equals 2 times 7x plus 8. Notice no fractions anymore. Brilliant. This is much easier. Multiplying this out, as you can see, you get 25x minus 50 equals 14x plus 16. And just quickly to solve that, we would take away the smaller one, which is 14x from both sides, and get rid of that minus 50 by adding 50 to both sides. This gives us 11x equals 66. So x is 6. Now here comes the moment of truth. What therefore is the answer to the question? Many of you would at this point say 42, and I don't blame you, but that's not actually right. Okay, x is 6. Therefore, if we use that original fraction, go back to that original fraction, 5x over 7x, putting 6 in, we get 30 on the top, that's cats, 42 on the bottom, that's dogs. And you're now protesting, you're going, but the question was asking about dogs. It says, how many dogs does the vet now have? 7 times 6 is 42, so why is it not 42? Well, I've written at the bottom, watch out for sneaky question phrasing. The question said, how many dogs does the vet now have in its care? If you look back at the last question, we were asking about the original situation. How many sweets did Philip have? Now we're asking about the new situation. Something has actually changed. It's not a hypothetical. It didn't say if 10 cats leave, then this would be the situation. It's telling us 10 cats have left. 8 dogs have joined its care. And now they want to know how many dogs does the vet now have after the changes. This is really important to focus on if you haven't seen this type of question before, because sometimes they can ask about the current new situation. When you find out what x is, you find out the multiplier and put it back into the original fraction, that gives you the original situation. 30 cats and 42 dogs. But if the question this time wants to know the new situation, well, if there were 42 dogs originally and 8 dogs join its care, there are now 50 dogs. So the answer is 50 dogs. I only shared that last example to show you how they can be slightly sneaky with the wording of the question, but did you notice how we solved it was identical to how we solved the last example? Create a fraction from the first ratio using x's, make the adjustments. Sometimes, by the way, the adjustments will only be on the top or only be on the bottom, not a big problem at all. Then make it equal to the new ratio, expressed as a fraction without any x's. Cross multiply, solve the equation, and then you have the multiplier. Put that multiplier back into the original fraction. Bob's your uncle, you have the original amounts. I will admit this doesn't come up a huge amount, but it could come up in either the GRE or the GMAT. So it's a nice, fun, quick trick to learn about that the vast majority of students don't know before I teach to them. So I really hope you like that trick and enjoyed the video. See you in the next one.